Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 1.2, Problem 6. This is Problem 6 from Section 1.2 of the homework. It says, for a popular new computer tablet, the supply equation is P equals S of Q equals 1Q plus 200, and the demand equation is P equals D of Q equals negative 2Q plus 800. And then based on that, there are five parts. The first part is part A. At a price of $300, how many tablets will be supplied? So since it's asking about supply, you have to pick the correct equation. And it's labeled supply equation, and the S in parentheses, S is for supply. So we will start with P equals S of Q equals 1Q plus 200. Now, once you've chosen which equation, supply and demand, I prefer not to write it with this S parentheses Q in the middle. We can simplify it up to P equals, instead of 1Q, we can just put Q plus 200. Now, it says, at a price of $300, how many tablets will be supplied? This is the supply equation. What you have to do is put in a 300 for one of the variables and solve for the other one. Now, since it says a price of 300, the 300 goes in for P. P is for price, Q is for quantity. So this becomes 300 equals Q plus 200. So now Q is the unknown, and to get it by itself, I can just subtract 200 from both sides. So minus 200 on the right, minus 200 on the left, and on the left, positive 300, negative 200 gives me 100. And on the right, I just have Q. The positive 200 and negative 200 cancel. So 100 equals Q. The quantity is 100. If the price was $300 per tablet, a quantity of 100 tablets will be supplied. The company that makes them will be willing to make 100 of them if they sell for $300. Part B says, if a quantity of 300 tablets is supplied, what is the price? So again, we start with the supply equation because the question asks specifically about what's supplied. So the supply equation is given in the original question. It is P equals S parentheses Q equals 1Q plus 200. Now again, this extra equal sign in S parentheses Q is to identify this as being the supply equation as opposed to the demand equation. Now that I know I've picked the right equation, because the question says supply, so I pick the equation for supply, I'll write it in its more simple form of P equals 1Q, or just Q if you want, you don't need the 1, Q plus 200. So now that we have this, it says at a quantity of 300, what's the price? So the 300 has to be put in for one of the two variables and you solve the other one. So this time, the quantity is 300 and Q is for quantity, P is price. So P equals Q plus 200 becomes 300 plus 200. And the math for that is fairly easy, 300 plus 200. Is 500, and that's the price, so it would be $500. So if the company is willing to supply 300 computer tablets, the price per tablet must be $500. Now, part C. At a price of $300, how many tablets will be demanded? In other words, how many will people be willing to buy? Consumers, how many will they want to purchase? So because this question asks about demand, I will select the demand equation, which is given in the original question. The demand equation is P equals D parentheses Q equals negative 2Q plus 800. Now again, the question asks about demand, so I pick the equation that has the capital D. D is for demand. Now that I know I've picked the correct equation, I don't need to write that extra part. I'm just going to write P equals negative 2Q plus 800. And now they're talking about a price of $300. What's the quantity demanded? That 300 will go in for one of my variables, and I solve for the other one. Now, in this part of it, the 300 is a price. It says, at a price of 300, how many will be demanded? So the 300 goes in for P. 300 equals negative 2q plus 800 and find the quantity. Again, q is for quantity. How many is quantity? So now to get that q by itself, let me move the 800 to the left, and I accomplish this by subtracting 800 on the right side and subtracting 800 on the left side. Now on the left, positive 300 negative 800 gives a result of negative 500, which you might think, oh, that could be wrong, but it's okay. So you're going to have negative 500 equals, on the right side of the equation, positive 800 and negative 800 cancel, it's going to equal negative 2q. So the two negatives will wind up canceling. So I want q, not negative 2q, so I'm going to divide out the negative 2. Negative 500 divided by negative 2 equals negative 2q divided by negative 2. And what's going to happen, negative 500 divided by negative 2 is positive 250. And negative 2q over negative 2, the negative 2's cancel. 250 equals q, so the quantity is 250. If the price is 300, shoppers or consumers will be willing to purchase 250, a quantity of 250 of these computer tablets. Part D says, if a quantity of 300 tablets was demanded, what was the price? So again, because it asks about demand, I'm going to select the demand equation, which is P equals D parentheses Q equals negative 2Q plus 800. And again, I picked this one because this is the equation for demand. This, you don't want to use supply when they ask for demand. So now that I know I've chosen the correct equation, I don't really need to write it with the extra D parentheses Q in it. I can shorten it up like this now that I know I have the equation I need to work with. And the question says, if a quantity of 300 tablets was demanded, what was the price? So the 300 is a quantity. It goes in for Q. Q is quantity. And I'll solve for P, P for price. So what you get is P equals the negative 2Q becomes negative 2 times 300 plus 800. So now negative 2 times 300 is negative 600. And I'm going to add that to 800. And negative 600 and positive 800, I get P is positive 200. And again, that's P, so this is a price. This would be $200. So if shoppers were willing to purchase a quantity of 300 of these computer tablets, the price must have been $200 each. And now part E, what is the market price? This is the big question, the market price. So for market price, we need to know, where does supply equal to demand? That's what we have to solve. That's the important question. Where does supply equal demand? So the supply equation was given to us as P equals S parentheses Q equals 1Q plus 200. And when is that going to be equal to the demand, which was given to us as P equals D parentheses Q equals negative 2Q plus 800? That's what we have to solve. Now, there's way too many equals writing it this way. So first of all, once you pick the correct equation, I feel that you don't need to write the D parentheses Q and the S parentheses Q. So we can get rid of that to start with. And they both have this P. We can get rid of that too. What I want to solve is 1Q plus 200 equals minus 2Q plus 800. For some value of Q, this equation is true. And that's going to determine the market price for me. So to solve for Q, let me move the minus 2Q over to the left. It'll become positive 2Q. So I'm going to go plus 2Q on both the left side and the right side. So when I do that, I'm going to have 3Q, 1Q plus 2Q is 3Q, plus 200 on the left, equals the negative 2Q and positive 2Q on the right cancel, equals 800. Now I want to move the 200 over with the 800. So I am going to subtract 200 on both sides. And that's going to give me 3Q on the left equals positive 800 and negative 200 will make 600. Now, if 3q equals 600, and if I divide out the 3, q is 600 divided by 3 is 200. Now, that's not the final answer. This is the quantity. A quantity of 200 tablets will be demanded. A quantity of 200 tablets will be supplied. But the question asks what the market price is, not the market quantity. The 200 is the market quantity. Q equals 200. Quantity equals 200. We have to now find the price. So what we can do is take our quantity of 200 and use it either in the supply equation or the demand equation and calculate the price. Put in the quantity of 200 and find the price. You can use either one. I find that the supply equation is a little bit easier because it doesn't have that negative in it. So the supply equation is P equals S of Q equals 1Q plus 200. And again, I don't need to write that S of Q. The S here is for supply, just to tell me which one I'm dealing with as opposed to demand. Now, we calculated that the market quantity is 200. I'm going to put the 200 in for Q. So 200 times 1 is really 200. 200 plus another 200 gives me P equals 400. And again, that's P, so it's a price that's going to be $400. And now if you have time, you can take that quantity of 200, try it in the demand equation also, and you'll see that the price also comes out to 400. And that will verify that you have the right answer. So the market price for these computer tablets is $400 each.